Hi, I'm Chris Foster, and today I'd like to talk to you about DataSets.jl, a bridge between code and data. So I work at Julia Computing on the Julia Hub team. This package has been developed as part of that work. So a lot of the time in technical computing, you have a code in a fairly functional style. You put some Julia data structures in, you get some Julia data structures out, and that's all in well and good. You probably have the data on your local disk. So during development, you're not worrying too much about where that data is coming from. When then you go to deploy that into a more production style situation, and things kind of get messy. So why do they get messy, and what do I hope we can do about this with datasets.jl? So one of the reasons things get messy is that data storage is just quite diverse. You obviously have your local file system, the data could be on there, but in production it could be on a cloud system like Amazon S3. It could be in a database somewhere for transactional consistency. Perhaps it's on your personal Google Drive if you're just doing a small project. So there's this diversity. There's also the fact that you don't want to download an entire large data set a lot of the time in production. Maybe it's several tens of terabytes and you have many computers processing it. You only want to download the pieces that you need. Another big reason, I think, is that data type isn't stored with the data a lot of the time. So you have maybe some file extensions or magic numbers at the start of a file that you can look at to try and figure out what kind of data you're dealing with. But that's kind of a sorry substitute for a full type system. Alternatively, your program just might assume that the data comes in a particular format and crash if it doesn't. And so you kind of get these assumptions baked into your code about what kind of data is that it can deal with. Whereas perhaps they should come with the data itself, so as metadata. So an example of this could be tabular storage, where you have many different types of tabular formats, but your code probably doesn't care that much about which format it comes in. You could have CSV, you could have gzip CSV, you might have Arrow, Parquet, or maybe it's a database connection and you have a view of that, of a table in the database. So datasets gives you a data.toml. It's more like a metadata model, but the default storage is data.toml, which can record this metadata about your dataset instances to tell you where the storage and where it's stored and what type it is. So what storage have we implemented so far? Obviously, there's a file system backend for local data. I've also got an embedded storage, which I'm hoping will help with Pluto integration as part of our of developing Julia Hub. We have a Julia Hub storage backend, which can give you access to public and private data sets within the Julia Hub compute platform. There's several different sort of storage workflows that you might want to consider. People talk a lot about reproducibility, so you might want to have your data toml next to your project and have it automatically loaded. So Julia datasets path is an environment variable which you can set to search for your data projects in a kind of configurable way. So that can be set to have a reproducible workflow, but that's not always what you want. If you're just experimenting, you might want to just have access to all the data on your local machine. So you can set up a data metadata store for that in your .julia directory. Or maybe you want to have data on a shared cluster where everyone shares a data toml, which tells you about the data environment of that cluster. So that's a bit about storage. What about type systems? So datasets is trying to bridge the type system inside your program with the types which are outside your program. Now, we all know kind of how to deal with data types within a program. You define some custom structs and everything is lovely. But data outside your program is kind of a mess, as I referred to before. You might do some kind of auto detection of what that is, or maybe you just assume it's a certain type. So the dataset basically provides a place, the dataset type provides a place to hang metadata about the data outside your program. So for instance, if you want to open some data with datasets.jl, you can use the dataset function to get the metadata out for a particular named dataset. And then you can map that into your program as a particular Julia type. So here we're mapping it in as a blob tree, which is basically a Git-like tree of blob data. If you want, you can leave this this Julia type off and there'll be a default. So for instance, if you have a single blob, you could open your dataset called blob name and you would get a blob out. So yeah, we've started with some file system-like abstractions for talking about the data outside your program, but I'd like to have a much richer system for talking about that. So now it's time for a super quick demo. Let's open up a REPL. Oops. So I've got a data toml here. I've got several things. I've got a project manifest and I have a data toml next to them. So let's have a quick look in here. I've got three different data sets. There's one of them. They have local file paths. These all are on local storage. So let's open up Julia with the current directory as the project. We'll load the library and let's have a quick look at the data REPL. So the REPL gives you a quick kind of overview of which data sets you have. So here we've got these three data sets and we can preview those with show. So let's have a look at this one. This is just a random binary file, so we can't see much in there. We can have a look at the text file and we've also got some tree-like data, so we can see that. It's a sort of nested tree. Okay, so that's the data REPL very quickly. And let's have a very quick look at how we can map data into our program. So let's say we open this binary data. By default, we get it as a blob, which lazily, so this doesn't necessarily download the data straight away, but it's a handle to the data. But we may want to open it more conveniently as a data buffer, so we can do that as well. So here you can see we've actually got it as a vector, and then we can do something immediately with that data. So this is sort of showing you how we can map data from a named data set into a particular Julia type within our program. So yeah, let's make data access less messy together. If you're interested in using this library, then be very happy to chat with you on the GitHub issues or on Slack if you prefer. Thanks for listening. Bye.